Today we're going to talk about what is casting, what is coming over the top, and the best part is how you can fix it. I'm PGA teaching professional Todd Cope, Director of Instruction for US Golf TV and the Sanford Power Golf Academy. And one of the best things a golf coach can do is help create clarity and eliminate confusion. I can tell you this, when it comes to casting or coming over the top, these terms, they have golfers confused to the nth degree. So be sure to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, and be sure to leave a comment. I like hearing from you. I like the questions. I even like hearing from those of you who disagree with me. That's okay, because I respond to all of them. So first of all, what is casting and what is coming over the top? In its most simplest form, casting is releasing the club, releasing the energy of the club too early. So the timing is off on when we're actually doing that. We're going to dive more deep into that in just a second. When we talk about coming over the top, we're talking about a directional issue. The club is not traveling in the direction that we want it to. So let's dive into each one of these. And like I said already, I'm going to give you a tip or a drill at the end of it to fix both of those. So let's first of all talk about coming over the top, because that's one I hear a lot of that people talk about. So coming over the top is basically when the club, the arms, the hands, the club is moving out and across the body. All right, and when the club moves out and across the body, it's not a terrible thing, but you're gonna be more prone to hitting slices, maybe struggling a little bit with contact, and probably struggling more so with your driver than maybe even your irons. And so when we talk about over the top, it's when the club moves out and across the body, and for a right-handed golfer, to the left. Now when we do this, as I said already, you're gonna be more prone to slicing the golf ball. So what about casting the club? Well, casting the club is when the club head, the stored energy in the club, releases too early. And when you look at people who hit the golf ball long ways, all right, they release the club, they release the stored energy at the moment of impact. And what that does is that allows them to hit the golf ball when the club is traveling at its fastest, when the club has reached peak capacity in terms of club head speed. So those are a little bit more in depth of the differences. So once again, over the top is directional, when the club moves out and across the body, kind of produces some slices, some things like that. Casting is when the club releases too early. So you might be asking yourself, do the two relate? And I think most of the time they do. If somebody's coming over the top, lots of times they're also casting. But it's not all the time. You could be coming from the inside of the golf ball, all right? The opposite of over the top. You'd be coming from the inside of the golf ball and also casting or releasing it too early. We do see that a lot also, all right? So the two do not always have to relate. So how are we gonna fix those? Well, you might have some drills already. If you've had some different drills that have helped you in terms of fixing casting the golf club or coming over the top, be sure to leave those in the comments or reference those, because I love new ideas. So first of all, let's talk about coming over the top. How are you gonna fix that? Well, I like to use this phrase that I call right knee, right field. All right, so I'm a right-handed golfer, so as I'm sitting here, I want to feel like my hands or my arms or the grip of the club, I don't care, but some reference point, I want to feel like that reference point works from my right knee up towards right field, because when it works that direction, that gets me swinging the club to the right, which is the opposite of over the top. So let me go ahead and hit a shot here. I'm going to get set in, and all I'm going to think about is my hands going from my right knee up to right field. So I'm set in, right knee, right field, swung the club out to the right, ball got up in the air and had a nice high draw to it. So if you feel like you're coming over the top, think of right knee, right field, and some reference point, your hands, the grip, the club head, doesn't matter, working in that direction. Now when it comes to releasing the club too early, casting the golf club, what I like to do is I like to use the power stick, because teaching lag or telling people to quit casting the club is, I mean, man, it is almost impossible to get them to quit doing it. So I like to use a training aid. So the training aid here in the power stick, really simple, it's got this formed grip on there. I love that because I can help my students get a good solid grip on it. It's got this nice light shaft, which is wonderful for tempo. And on a side note, there's a difference between swinging hard and swinging fast. And in order to swing fast, which is what you want, you gotta have good temple. And the nice light shaft that's pretty flexible allows you to do that. So pretty simple, you set in here, it's got this bullet right here, it's got a magnet, kind of like a magnet bullet on here. And all you do is you just go ahead and swing it, and you hear the pop. And what I tell my students is, hey, let's see if we can hear the pop on the front side, the target side of the golf ball. So back, boom. And if they can hear the pop over there, then I know that they're increasing their leg and keeping it. The opposite of that would be back there, popping it back there. You could hear the pop happen back there. That would be casting the club or releasing it too early. The beauty of this too is that you don't have to hit golf balls. You can swing it at home, and I can tell you this, this definitely adds some distance to the shots. So I don't care if you're casting the club, I don't care if you're coming over the top, you've got to understand the difference of the two, and you got to have a way to fix it. If you do those things, it's going to help you play better golf.